This is my solstice, summer solstice evening, visit to the ocean. Thank you. was hoping some fog would come in. Feels good to sit. This log is wet and I don't really feel like my butt getting soaked. Plus, it's better for me to walk around. Oops, I have to adjust my sweatshirt. There's some other adjustments I'll do on my camera at a different time, but all the width and everything that I have is widescreen. I looked up a video on what's the best to use on the beach, and they said widescreen. So makes sense to me. I thought I turned it off. But I want to get closer to the water too. Nobody ever puts logs very close to the water. hard to describe how the air smells here. The only time I've ever been to a ocean before was at the Gulf of Florida. Back in 1992, I think. I took my very first vacation with a friend of mine. We went to Fort Myers, Florida. And we were going to Sanibel Island and Captiva Island. And the minute I got off the plane, you know, I always hear about how wonderful the ocean smells. Well, the minute I got off the plane, it hit me with the most horrible stench of dead fish and dead shellfish I've ever smelled. So we went in the middle of April, so I don't know if there was some algae thing going on, but we got used to it after we went to the hotel and everything. But that was nasty. Oh my gosh. And we went to the Ding Darling Nature Reserve, which is really cool down there. And there was a restaurant that had the best seafood I've ever had in my life. And it was called the Mucky Duck. And the view on the beach was amazing. We got to watch the sunset. That was my first ocean sunset. And it was beautiful. And there were people standing with us from all over the world that went to that place. And the seafood was amazing. It was a really, really cool restaurant. Visit and everything. Another thing I couldn't stand about Florida, the beach there anyway, is the white sand is gorgeous, beautiful, but you get sand fleas. And my friend and I were laughing at why do they have showers on the beach? We're coming from, the top of the United States, where it's 60 below, wind chill winters. We've never been to the ocean. We didn't know anything about it. And the sand fleas, we got in the car and went back to the hotel room. We had sand all over the place. And all of a sudden, we woke up the next morning and our legs were completely covered in sand flea bites. It was horrible. It was like getting chiggers down south. And I've had chiggers before. They're nasty. But the sand fleas, oh my gosh. I never saw anything like that. And we had to go to the pharmacy to get some kind of scratch cream, and they said that's what the showers are for on the beach, is to shower the sand off so those sand fleas don't come with you. So we had to have our car cleaned and everything, our rental car. It was really bad. So but here they don't have them here, which is fantastic. So I'm very, very happy about that. You know, something can be really beautiful, but it can hide stuff that's just awful. Florida's got some beauty. And I'm thankful I didn't move there, because they have, they'll get some dust storms that come all the way from, I don't know if it's African or Malaysian or what, But the dust storms are awful. And the water gets completely filthy. And they have some really bad algae that they can get too. And this is on the Gulf side. I don't think it's on the Atlantic side, on the other side. And I couldn't be around that because of my COPD. That can really, really harm me. So, plus they've got, you know, the heat. We've got the humidity here. When it's 60 degrees and the humidity is 90%, it's not hot, trust me. Yeah, you'll sweat maybe, but it's not like being in Florida when it's 90, 100 degrees, and then you've got the humidity. That's horrendous. I mean, I spent 23 years in Arizona, or in Phoenix. I'm not from there at all, but that was, you know, they always say it's a dry heat. Well, they're right. I never sweat. I've never sweated in Arizona. I don't normally sweat. So, but here, the only time I sweat when I'm in the forest. When I go down at the bottom of that little ravine where all the water is. And that's just fine. I mean, it's good to sweat, I heard. And then they have these, I hate bugs. I don't have a bug phobia or whatever. Well, yeah, I guess I do for certain bugs. And they have those, what are those bugs called in Florida? The mating bugs. And I watched a couple of videos about those. Those are horrible in Florida. And they showed what damage they can do to people's cars. Oh, the love bugs. I'm like, that's horrendous. But where I was gonna move, I was gonna go to Panama City Beach, Florida. And I didn't see any big problem with love bugs there. Of course, you know, the gators and then the hurricanes. I will never have to deal with that here. But we have the Cascadian Fault. I think it's called the Cascadian Fault. And it's way overdue of having the big one. And big earthquakes. And if they get the big one, they'll take our town right out. The whole coast will be gone. And every day there's hurricane, or every day there's earthquakes off the coast. Some of them get 4.0. Sometimes even bigger. I don't feel them, but there's hundreds of them. And that fault line is, according to the scientists, that's getting ready to go. So, I mean, what can I say? Anywhere you go, unless you go to like Iowa, or, well, Iowa, they've got tornadoes. Nowhere in the country you can go and be safe from everything. So, I've been in everything possible, and I except for a hurricane. And I thought, you know what, I don't really feel like being alligator food. So, they have great white sharks off this coast in these waters too. So if we have the big earthquake, well, guess what? I'll be shark food. You know what? I'd rather be shark and fish food than alligator food. So my overall health, except for my previous health issues, but my overall health and my skin and stuff, it's way better here than in Arizona. I'm not dehydrated all the time. There's no pollution here in this town whatsoever. The drinking water comes from, I think it's called Schooner Creek. The drinking water is, well, it's filtered, you know, in the water plant or whatever it's called here. But the water tastes really good. There's no, it's actually quite soft. There's no white crap all over the glasses, all over the sink, like there was in Arizona. Calcium deposits, none of those. So, but yeah, the water pH is soft, or the water is soft here. And that's why my clothes feel so good. Tub here, the water feels great. I like taking baths and I like showers. So the tide is high. Got high tide at about 7:30, I think, and then it's about 9. It's about 8:45, 9 now. The sunset's supposed to be 9:09. Sit down is if I listen to these waves while I'm sitting, I'll fall asleep. It just relaxes me so much. Oh, nice. Get a little peek of the sun there. almost all alone always makes me smile. I have major human anxiety. I really do. PTSD, but crying out loud. I've had therapy for it. Basically, at the end of therapy, he's like, "Oh, you're doing really good. You should be able to socialize now." I'm like, "Okay, thank you very much. Thanks for all your time for the last 2 years." And then I smile and walk out. And then I go home and I'm by myself and I'm happier than a pig and shit, man. I'll say it, I've said it before and I'll say it again. I'm not afraid of the dead. Not at all. I'm afraid of the living. Not a real smart idea to be by myself all the way down here, away from any exits when it gets dark. So I think I'm gonna hang around until it gets dark this time. And then I'll walk home and I'll turn the camera off. And then I'll walk home. The camera didn't do too good in the dark last time when I was walking home. I would love to have a night vision camera. Or I wish they had a GoPro with night vision. That would be awesome to see the wildlife. You always gotta put yourself somewhere where you have an exit. Yeah, this is a nice town and everything. But believe me, there's whack jobs also. And there's whack jobs everywhere. But a woman should not ever put herself at a disadvantage. Never. Always have an exit plan. walk all the way down to the end of that sometime. There's got to be some kind of exit down there. I'm sure you guys get bored of the same old beach all the time. I don't, but I'd like to walk down on the other end too sometime. Bunch of fires. It's 1, 2, 5 fires. There are 5 campfires. At least they're starting to put the campfires further down, which is good because with my COPD I can't breathe that smoke. Got me. Coming from the ocean. I wonder what the beach looks, or what this looks like at night. Probably looks pretty cool with the fires. Something on the news that there was a woman, and I don't remember where it was. A woman was walking along a beach, and she totally sank, just like quicksand. I don't know if it was Florida, or if it was in California, or somewhere else, but her body just completely went, it was like she went into a sinkhole. And I think she was rescued, but holy cow. That would be scary. Well, my fat ass would probably stop me from going all the way in. So that's a plus. Well, I'm not that fat, but this woman was really thin. Again, except for my blue jeans. So walking to my apartment is taking my life in my hands. Try not to get hit by a car. Well, it's not like it's a freeway or anything. I mean, seriously, I'm in a rural little 10,000 people town, but some of them drive like absolute idiots. A lot of drunk drivers too. Okay, 9:24. I suppose I'd better go. Well, I hope you enjoyed my solstice at the sea video. Take care. Much love to all of you. See ya.